Hi, and welcome back to A Beginner's Guide to Toon Boom Harmony. Now that we've covered vector drawings, let's move on to bitmap drawings. And first of all, let's see the fundamental differences between the two. So first, we open a scene and we have our default view, and our default layer. The default layer will always be in vectors. So we're going to keep this and create a bitmap layer and see the differences between the two. So we're going to rename this vectors. Click OK. Create a new layer and tick bitmap everywhere here. And add and close and call this bitmap. So we're going to use just the basic brush and maybe a little bit bigger. Create a brush stroke on the vectors layer and another one using just the basic soft lead brush here on the bitmap layer. A little bit bigger. And if we zoom in, if we go beyond 100%, and you can see here I'm beyond 1000% of zoom, you can see that the vectors will always remain sharp. But if we look at bitmap, because it's blurry, it still looks okay. But if you start zooming in, you will see the pixels. And that's because the main differences between vectors and bitmaps is that bitmaps is a grid of pixels, whereas vectors are shapes created from vectors and from Bezier curve, which means that they do not have a contour made of pixels. They have a contour made of a curve. And the main difference, and you can already see here, is that bitmap layers, while they have this disadvantage of having a limited zoom in them, have the ability to have not only transparency, blurriness, but most importantly, and you can see when you look in your brushes, in your tool properties here, bitmap have the ability to have texture brushes. And this is the main reason to use bitmap layers, bitmap drawing layers. They have texture brushes. And this is why we use them anyways. So let's remove this. Also, while I'm in tool properties, let me show you how you can, if you want, create or just change an existing brush. Keep in mind this works the same with the brushes in vector drawing. But let's just say I want something from this brush, but a little bit different. You click on this little arrow here and you find yourself with this window. If you're used to using Photoshop or any other software that has custom brushes, you probably recognize most of those options, like shape of the tip, transparency. It's important to know that in Toon Boom, it's very, very primitive tool for bitmap brushes. So most of the things like transparency, when you get minimum and maximum, the minimum and the maximum depend on pen pressure. For example, this has a minimum size and a maximum size. The minimum size depends on pen pressure. If I put minimum size to the max, I will always have the same size, for example. I encourage you to just mess around with this and try to create your own brushes, and just try to find what suits you the best. Once you have created a brush from another one, you can add it in your list by clicking the little plus sign here, new brush, and give it a name. One of the brushes I use the most is this one. It's pretty efficient. It gives a pretty decent pencil line to it, and it's pretty comfortable to work with it. I'll just show you the presets. I think I made it from the either the wax crayon or colored pencil brush. And here you have the presets. If you want to copy them, this is for the tip. I don't use a dual tip. Here is for transparency, and here is for paper texture. Make sure to copy that if you want to use this brush. I personally kind of like it. Now, so we've seen that one of the issue with working in bitmap drawings is the limited resolution. How we can work with that is, let's see. If we zoom in, we see pretty early the pixels appearing. We can, if we want, increase the resolution of the scene we are currently working in. To do that, you go into Scene Settings, and in Bitmap Resolution, you increase default pixel density. By default, it will be at 100%. If you bring it to 200%, what this means is the area within your camera here will be at twice the resolution of your scene. Your scene is still in full HD, aka 1080p by 1920p, but the area within which you are drawing will be in the equivalent of 4K. And you can take that further if you want by going back into scene settings and bitmap resolution and going up to 400%. And this means that what I draw in here will be basically in 4K resolution. But you can see that if I push the value too much, the software starts chugging, which is normal. Even with a good computer, you have your limits. So I recommend using 200%. It's pretty good, and it's not even necessary to work beyond that. Now that we've seen that, let's see some tools that don't work in bitmap or that behave differently compared to vectors. So you can see that even though you have your brush tool, you don't have your pencil line. You don't have your pencil tool here, and you don't have the polyline here. You still have line, rectangle, and ellipses, but the lines that will be created with these tools will still be lines that are in bitmaps, and you can see they still have pixels in them. So not only do you not have those tools, you don't have the contour editor either, because it's just made to edit Bezier curve, and in bitmap you can't have a Bezier curve. And one other important thing that changes in bitmap layers is the selection tool. If I make several brush strokes, unlike with the vector brushes, when I try to select one brush stroke, it will always select all all the brush strokes within the layer. This is not something that you can change. The only workaround that you can do to work around that, if you want to just change size or the position or the rotation of just a few brush strokes within your drawing in a bitmap layer, is to use the cutter tool. The cutter tool that we showed earlier has several uses, and one of its other uses is to use it as kind of a lasso, even though Toon Boom doesn't have anything close to a proper lasso tool, but it lets you select a part of your drawing and edit it the same way you would with your selection tool. So you still have your rotation, your scaling, your skews, and everything that comes with it. So that's basically it for the tools that don't work in bitmap layers. And one other thing, which is not really a tool but a more of a function, is the ability to create color art from line art. Again, because it's not vectors, you can't transfer the vectors from one art layer to the other. But the art layer, of course, still work. And one last thing that is different is the palette. You will have a very different palette. You don't have your list of colors, and you don't have the limited amount of colors from your palette. You just create your colors here with your three values here, hue, saturation, and value. And you can add colors. And as I said, because the art layers are still here, you still have the ability to draw behind and draw in front of certain layers. And you can see that when I select something, I will only select what is on the current layer, art layer I'm using. And that's about it for all the differences between bitmaps and vectors. And I think you can already figure out what are the advantages and disadvantages of each way of drawing. Bitmaps are more useful when you want to have this sketchy feel to your drawing, when you want the ability to have a better brush for freehand drawing, since it has textures, it has transparency and all that. And vectors are more for cleaner look, for inking and stuff like that. And with that done, we finally covered the most important tools for drawing in Harmony, and we can finally move on to animating. I'm sorry it's taking so long to get into actual animation, but I wanted to make sure you get a good grasp of what the drawing tools in Toon Boom can offer first. Also, before I end this video, I'd like to mention I have put up a Discord server where you can chat, share your work done in Toon Boom, ask for help on any issue you might have, or give suggestions for future videos. With that said, join me next time as we start tackling the timeline. Until then, experiment with what you've learned so far and try to find or create brushes that you're comfortable working with. And of course, take care.